Here is how we measure the effectiveness of radiation therapy for your prostate cancer. Post-radiation therapy follow-up is very important. The key features of follow-up will include a history, a physical examination, and laboratories, including the PSA study. The PSA evaluation is obtained on a routine basis for several years because that will give us a biochemical measurement of the success of radiation therapy. The analysis of the PSA serial evaluations will include perhaps every 3-month studies, tracking the PSA decline for our patients. It may take upwards of 1.5 to 2 years, to perhaps sometimes 3 years, to truly evaluate the lowest point of the PSA drop after radiation therapy. This is called the nadir, and this will essentially show us how successful radiation therapy was. You want to have a PSA that is less than 1, ideally, and this has been shown to be correlated with great success rates.
Some prostate cancers are high risk, aggressive, and more likely to spread. Others are low risk, least likely to have bad outcomes. The biopsy says cancer, but current diagnostic tools provide limited information about how aggressive a man's individual disease is. So most men decide to treat prostate cancer immediately. Once treated, many men experience serious long-term side effects, like incontinence and sexual impotence. Immediate treatment isn't always needed, but right now a man can't be sure if his cancer is the kind that is likely to require treatment or if he's okay to wait for now. What if there was a test that could determine how aggressive prostate cancer is? Genomic Health is developing a new test to do just that. By reviewing the underlying biology of the tumor and using genes from multiple biologic pathways, the test can predict the aggressiveness of prostate cancer when diagnosed, allowing a man to make a more informed treatment decision with confidence, taking care of himself with more information and greater peace of mind.